What's up, Internet? This is Random Game Critic, and welcome back to Spyro the Dragon. Last time we made it through, Dry Canyon, and now, these are the first totally flame-proof enemies of the game. Not only do they have a little shield, like, that's not a shield, it's like a little metal cloak. I never noticed that. How the hell does that even work? Whatever, I don't think you can kill him, though, with flames, can you? Unless he tries to swing and miss. Okay, you definitely cannot kill him. You have to charge through him, let's just put it that way. That's the first enemy of the game you actually have to charge through. He's got a little dagger there. And this enemy here obviously cannot charge this fat lady, but she doesn't hurt you, oddly enough. All she does is just bitch slaps you away. But if she slaps you off a cliff, that can be a problem. You just notice there, I flame breath the cauldron, it turns red and pops a gem out. Nice. I like free money. that reminds me of Spryo, you're the dragon, or at some point Moneybags, when you pay him gems, Moneybag goes, "My goodness, Spryo, where do you find all these gems? Can you just pick them off the ground?" Haha, he starts laughing. And I'm like, yeah, kinda. Picking up money off the ground, that'd be so nice. More money. Just laying on the ground, that'd be cool. Whatever. These are frill lizards that just disintegrate. That's so cruel. Gotta kill you also, because we can. Even though that lady is totally harmless, though. Well, not really totally harmless. She can still kill us, but... whatever. So, this is Cliff Town, obviously. I don't even think I've said that yet, have I? The stage is called Cliff Town. Bit late for that. There's a thief here. You gotta chase in a circle until you kill him. Again, Flame Breath Charge works best for me. Now I have 5 Dragon Egg, which is enough for me to skip World 3. No joke, I can skip to World 4 now if I wanted to. But I'll just kill more of these guys, though, because we get money for it. Okay. I don't know what to talk about now. One time, actually, in a failed recording of this, it wasn't in my previous LP, it was in a failed recording of my previous LP, where the music glitched out like crazy. It just, like, skipped to the same note for several minutes now. It was insane. Got a little interrupted there, whatever. Let's go rescue Halvor. Sure.
How's a dragon supposed to flame metal armor, anyway?
Remember, Spyro, flame won't harm metal, but charging with your horns, that should do the trick.
Now, I love how they keep giving you tips on stuff that you should have known a long time ago. Honestly, if you didn't know that, you would have been dead by now. So they're a little slow there, guys, but... ah, well, at least I knew what I was doing beforehand, though. Otherwise, I would have been screwed, wouldn't I? I guess not really. I just keep on rambling, don't I? I have a bad habit of just rambling on and on. Well. Now, I think there's more stuff to collect over here, or I can miss completely. Okay, there we go. So it's a yellow gem, you can't get up there, or anywhere else around this area, really. So the only way to go is up. Where there's a bunch of ladies here that'll try to knock you off the tower. But that's never a problem, though. This game's actually really easy now that I look back on it. But that's okay, though, I guess. Except having a game that'd be too challenging. Well, I've already been over this numerous times, haven't I? There's no such thing as too much challenge, as long as it's a fair challenge. Like, if the controls are challenging, then that's not a good thing. If it's challenging, like, my definition of a challenge is that if you die and if it is entirely your fault, then that's a good challenge. That is a fair challenge. Otherwise, it is not. Anyways, here I am rambling again. There's nothing much to talk about in this game, though. This is all stuff we've seen already. Except the end of the level's over here, but we're not done yet, though. anyway, close the done yet. You'll see in minutes. First thing we can do is we can actually glide from here to over here. There's a firework here. Obviously, we can light it with fire. And there it goes. There it goes. And it destroys the chest over there. Because you can't kill a chest normally. I've already been through this. Anyways. Another thing I haven't pointed out is that if you flame breath the chest, the gem will just pop up and sit there. If you charge through it, the gem will follow you. That was weird. That camera, what the? Okay, fine. Gotta climb back up now. I also love to, like, hold square and X, and you jump repeatedly like this. I don't know why, but I swear on some surfaces, like if you're going upward, I swear it's faster. I hate jumping up steps, though. What's wrong with walking up them? Whatever. Let's go rescue... hit my face in the wall, and then rescue Enzo.
Hey, what's on the other side of that river?
Why don't you glide there and find out?
Other side of the river, huh? So we're gonna check out a checkpoint in case I screw up, and glide to the other side of the river, and there is a whole other area over here. Again, I told you we weren't done yet. We're probably about halfway done with the level now. This is a big stage. It's a lot like Stone Hill, only it's not nearly as spread out, though. This, like, big plains area over here isn't as big as Stone Hill was, which I like. And again, as a kid, I felt like I was exploring, like I opened up a whole new world. I was so excited to find this secret that isn't all that impressive. the memories. That's why I love this game, because I loved it so much as a kid. Even though half the time I didn't know what the hell I was doing as a kid, I still loved it. And I remember in Mario Bros., I walked straight into the first Goomba. Okay, enough about my personal life. Let's just get on with playing the game. How about that? And kill more vultures, because that's what dragons do these days. Okay, there you go. You know, apparently these days, dragons are immortal and love to shout at people. According to Skyrim, which I can't stop hearing about. Oh, damn it. We do have Skyrim, though, and it is pretty fun. A bit overrated, if you ask me, but I'll just shut up and get this guy out of Crystal Marco. Polo!
You've reached the highest point in Clifftown. You can get to almost anywhere from here. If I were you, I'd use that whirlwind there.
What whirlwind? Well, this whirlwind of ow. So we've actually opened up a shortcut by rescuing this dragon. One thing I actually totally forgot to mention, though, I guess I should probably show it off real quick. Let's go ahead back over here again. The dragon on top that told us to glide across the river, rescuing him opens up this shortcut. So you actually open up shortcuts with some dragons once in a while, which is pretty cool. Rather than have to go all the climb all the way back up and then glide all the way back over the river again, that would be really annoying, so... It's smart that they put this in here. So that's a really nice shortcut here. Now, we've reached the highest point in Clifftown, blah blah blah, we can now get more gems over here. Couldn't get these before, and they're really expensive gems, aren't they? Both tens. There's another seven. And that looks like about it, but it's not, as you can clearly see. So the last few gems are in a pretty evil place. I'm not gonna lie, this is a pretty bizarre secret. You go behind the start of the level over here. Pretty clever, I'm not gonna lie. Now again, when you charge through the chest, the gem follows you. And it's a pink gem, which is 25, as I've already told you. Anyway, so I think that should be it for Clifftown then. Unless I screwed up another gem like I did last time. Nope, 400 out of 400. So next time on Spyro the Dragon, we're going to be entering one of my favorite stages of the game, actually. Next time we're going into Ice Cavern. I'll see you guys there.